Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.5 Beta 3. iOS 17.5 Beta 3 is out to developers and soon to public beta testers, usually by the time you're watching this video or the following day. And this update came in at 626.8 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 15 Pro Max, was about the same size on the iPad and the other iPhones here as well. Along with this, Apple also released many different updates with iPadOS 17.5 Beta 3, watchOS 10.5 Beta 3, along with tvOS and HomePodOS 17.5 Beta 3, macOS 14.5 Beta 3, visionOS 1.2 Beta 3, and other older Mac updates as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about. And as you can see, the build number is 21F5063F. And the F actually has moved back from what we had before, but that's okay as the build number has moved forward. Now this particular update does include a modem update, and that's on the 15 Pro Max and others that I've seen, such as the 13 Pro Max. So that should help with overall connectivity or just some changes on the back end to get things working properly. As far as new features, well, there are some changes here, and the first one has to do with Apple News. Last week, we learned that there's new puzzles and things within Apple News, and there's a new settings for that as well. So if we go into settings and then go down to News, under News, scroll down, you'll see that there's a new setting for News and Puzzles, specifically for News Plus. If you turn this on, it's a new Game Center toggle, and it allows you to send your results to Game Center to see how you rank among friends and other solvers on today's puzzles. Also, there was a little splash screen or pop-up that came up when I was in News, and you'll see it says Get More Coverage, specifically under Sports, where it says Tap Scorecards for more information about any game. So they continue to push this, and if we go into News, you'll see we've got some new games here, and I'm signed in where we have quartiles, and we're signed into this device, and then we can play this and then see how we rank within our rankings within Game Center. So if you want to play those games, those are all available now with a toggle if you want to turn that off altogether. Now with iOS 17.5 Beta 2, Apple added the option for users in the EU to install apps from a browser outside the App Store if the developer chooses. There were all sorts of new options that showed up and a whole new section under settings that had app installation. However, this week with iOS 17.5 Beta 3, each app gets more information in the EU regarding the developer and more. So you'll see here we have not only the language, but we have the app information for the specific app, as well as app marketplace information where it talks about where it was installed from, who the developer of the marketplace was, and then you can view it in the App Store. If you installed this app from a third-party app store, of course, this information would be different. So this has just been updated to help those in the EU. Also in the EU, the first time you install a new browser and then maybe set it as default, such as Arc Search, there's a new pop-up or screen that will come up letting you know that you've set it as a default browser and that you can change this within your settings. So we've long had the option to set a different browser as our default. So if we go down to Arc Search, for example, we can change it to whatever we'd like. They just have a new screen that actually informs them of that. Within previous updates, we actually got a new feature for stolen device protection. That's under Face ID and Passcode, so let's go into that. If we scroll down in Face ID and Passcode, we have stolen device protection. If we go into this and then turn it on, there's actually a new way it's handling this a little bit. If we turn it on, you'll see it says always from familiar locations or always, and then it will give you a security delay. If I try to turn this off, it verifies and then gives me a security delay. However, the first time you set this up, it will now actually not require it. In fact, there's a message where it says a security delay is not required because stolen device protection was recently turned on and the iPhone is still being set up. So if you turn this on right away, you didn't mean to, then you can actually not have that as a feature or something that's in the way of you continuing to set up your phone. Something that should make our lives a little bit easier that Apple has added in the latest beta is a new Apple Universal Link for eSIM installation. If you're in the United States and don't have a SIM card that's physical, or maybe you're using a secondary eSIM, there's now a new way that you can use a new Apple Universal Link to install that eSIM. And I'll show you that a little bit later as it's referenced in the release notes. Also, a few other things I wanted to mention that are specifically within the code is an assessment mode for iPads that are mentioned. There's also many small wording changes throughout, whether that's spelling corrections or other things, such as in the settings, if we go to battery, under the word optimization, some of the spelling has actually changed depending on where you are. Also, there's just small things throughout with screen time and more as far as just wording changes. So not huge updates, but things Apple is correcting. Now, as far as iOS 18, I wanted to mention one thing that people have been saying now that the new calculator app, or the calculator app we've really had all along, is finally going to be coming to iPad. Of course, they made one for Mac. There's not really a reason not to have it for iPad as well. So it looks like the next version will get that. And that will go along with the new iPads that we expect to be announced at the new Apple event Apple introduced today. Apple sent out invites for their virtual event. You'll see it here. And it says it's on 5/7 or May 7th at 7 a.m. Pacific time, or that would be 10 a.m. or Eastern time. And you can watch it on Apple.com, Apple TV, or YouTube as well. And this is actually called Let Loose. So this event, let me refresh here, has a little animation you can see with an Apple Pencil. We expect some iPads, and I have a whole separate video going over everything else to expect as far as iPads and accessories and more. Now, things they haven't added to iOS 17.5 yet that maybe they won't at this point since it's not here in beta 3 is the live activity for the stopwatch. I've mentioned this many times and it's something I really liked in early betas of iOS 17.4, but they haven't added it. It's still just there for things such as the timer, but not for the stopwatch specifically. So why they haven't brought that back, I'm not sure. I would love to see many more live activities. Also, there's no mention as far as Apple Music SharePlay using it for HomePod or Apple TV just yet. So those things we're still waiting for. Lots of different changes are in beta 1 as well that are still carrying over, such as the podcast app widget where we actually press play. We'll go ahead and press play on that, and it changes to the album art color that we're actually playing the podcast from. So lots of things are still here, but the original issue I mentioned, or some of the things I'd like to see from 17.4, haven't been brought back. Apple has already updated their release notes, and if we go into the feedback app, we can take a look at the latest bug fixes and features, and you'll see they've fixed some things with accessibility. Accessibility AbleNet Hook Plus Assistive Switch MFI accessory. It's just basically some coding updates, as well as resolved issues with app tracking transparency. Core Motion has some new features to respect users' privacy. And also the feature I mentioned earlier with eSIM, it says new Apple Universal Link for eSIM installation. Universal links should be all lowercase. Only the GSMA activation code passed in card data is customized for the carrier's information. So this is something that should make it a little bit easier. And there's also resolved issues with StoreKit. And there's a new issue with wallpaper that's mentioned where it says add new wallpaper sheet does not load any content after restoring a device. There is a workaround to reboot and change the wallpaper from the lock screen. And that's something that's still here. Something else that's still here is when we swipe down the notification center and then swipe back, you'll see it actually still dims the wallpaper as well. Why they're still having issues with wallpaper, I'm not sure, but it's not really a priority as far as the usability. It's just more of an annoyance. Also, something though that is more of an annoyance that we can't do yet is actually edit the lock screen or the standby screen. This is something I thought they would have fixed by now, but let's go ahead and lock the device, give it a second to go into standby. And once you edit this for the first time, if you press and hold, you can't do anything. You can go in and see some of the information, but you can't edit the clocks. There's just no way to do it. It won't recognize the tap or anything else. So Apple has yet to fix that. There are other bugs throughout, I'm sure, but one thing that's working well for me is actually Apple CarPlay. It's not disconnecting. We'll have to give it a few days and see if that continues to be a problem. When it comes to the overall performance, many people are already saying this update is very fast and smooth. And we'll take a look at the benchmarks in a moment, but if we go into things such as music here, you'll see it load. Scrolling is smooth. If we switch maybe menus here, go to library, everything looks to be pretty good overall. This update hasn't been slow as far as that goes. And if we scroll through, ProMotion is nice and fast, although it may take a moment more just to ramp up, but that could be due to battery saving. But overall performance seems to be pretty good. When it comes to the heat of the device, so far it's stayed nice and cool. Surprisingly throughout this video, it usually warms up a little bit. It's nice and cool to the touch. Again, this will take a few days to measure for sure and see what it's like. If we go into settings and take a look at battery life, battery health says normal, we're at 99% capacity and down to 165 cycles. Some people have actually seen their capacity jump down a little bit over the previous updates. However, this doesn't affect it specifically. It's just recalculating what's available once you install an update. But so far it looks pretty good. As far as the overall battery life itself, I have 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen active time today, 1 hour and 9 minutes of screen idle time, and I'm down to 65%. Battery life has been okay, but not great. I usually get down to about 30 to 40% by the end of the day, sometimes a little bit lower depending on what I'm doing. So you can see my usage throughout the days. It hasn't been great, but it does seem to be improving over iOS 17.4.1 for me. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.5 Beta 3, if you have Beta 2 installed, you definitely can. As far as its stability, though, we need to give it a few more days, and I'll talk about that in the weekend follow-up video. But it will take a few days to know how stable it is, but it seems to be pretty good so far. But if you're trying to fix something from iOS 17.4.1, I'd probably wait maybe until the release candidate or the final public release. As far as iOS 17.5 Beta 4, well, we do expect that probably next week. It seems we're on a weekly schedule at this point, so probably on April 30th or maybe May 1st. And then, of course, we have that Apple event on May 7th. Based off of that, I would expect probably a release candidate sometime around the week of May 7th, and then probably a final release on the 13th if Apple plans to release those iPads on the 17th. We don't know the actual timeline yet, but as we get closer to that event, I'm sure we'll learn more. As far as iOS 17.4.2, well, we could see an update, but it seems unlikely at this point. There's no mentions of it anywhere in the analytics that I'm aware of at this point, and it seems like Apple's just waiting for iOS 17.5. Also, iOS 18 Beta 1 is coming on June 10th, so we'll see that, and we'll have iOS 18 betas along with iOS 17 betas at the same time, all the way until the final public release, typically in early September. So I'm looking most forward to that, as that's where we'll see all of the feature updates. Let's take a look at the benchmarks. If we go into Geekbench 6, I ran this pretty quickly after installing the update as the device was cool, but overall it's pretty good just for a start. I have 2,880 for single core, 7,125 for multi-core. Compared to what we had this weekend, and again, keep in mind I ran this right after installing the update, it is a little bit lower, but I would expect that to bump up after I test it again, after things have finished processing in the background. So that's everything in iOS 17.5 Beta 3 so far. If you found any additional features or changes, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.